Magandang hapon, magandang araw, wherever you are, mga kabisa. This is Chris Aranda, kabisang Chris Aranda po dito sa Immigrant Visa Center, Amerika at iba pa. Wala tayong kanta ngayon. Wala tayong opening billboard dahil inagaw po ng Zoom ang ating sound. But what you can see dito sa inyong screen, ayan, what you can see there is that the Appropriations Committee has released its funding bill for the USCIS. So that's good news. Good news in the sense that the USCIS would have fees or would have the funds to continue operations, except that ang nangyari yata dito, the Appropriations Committee, and let's go to our, so again, balita, okay? So that's why we have our express visa bulletin, express report, because of this breaking news about the USCIS getting its funding, because that's good news for our immigrant visa applicants who are waiting for their interview dates and interview notices. Because if the USCIS has its funding, kung nakuha niya yung kanyang funding, di mabuti, because then USCIS will not have to lay off employees and yung processing ng inyong petition sa USCIS would continue. If you have a petition pending, if you have an application for adjustment of status pending, extension of stay pending, and naturalization pending, kumusta ka dyan, Ms. Maan? Ms. Maan Palmeri sa US. Okay, so yan po yung ating balita sa immediately, and then we'll go to our topic. Let's have a peek into the days ahead. Okay, yung ating kaibigang si Meow Mix. A peek into the days ahead. And what is it? The visa bulletin is wala pa rin hanggang ngayon. Hindi pa lumilitaw ang visa bulletin. So let's check kung may visa bulletin na. Let's go to our visa bulletin and see if the visa bulletin, the Department of State has the visa bulletin for now. And you're watching it as I am watching it, because we are coming to you live. So ito po yung visa bulletin for July 2020. Ayan, nakikita ninyo, andito po, ayan o. July 2020, current visa bulletin. Pero wala pang August. Ang August ay coming soon. Alright? And again, this is a live report. So what you're seeing on your screen is exactly what I am reporting. So balik po tayo sa ating ulat. Visa bulletin and USCIS processing. So if you do not have the visa bulletin, we have the USCIS processing that nakuha po natin. That was July 15. And how the immigration ban affects your visa petition, processing, and visa issuance worldwide. If you have any question, you can text or call us 63-917-531-8472. You can text or call us, because our staff would be standing by to answer your questions. Even if you're in Metro Manila, outside Metro Manila, you're outside the Philippines, wherever you are, you can call our number. That's +63-917-531-8472 or +63-917-526-8472. So that if you have any questions, you don't have to message me. You can text or call our number. You can get immediate answers. So pinag-iisipan ni President Trump, should I extend, sabi ni President Trump, let's see. Should I extend the cancellation of or the ban of the immigrant visa ban after December 31st, 2020? What if hindi ako ma-elect? Anong magagawa ko? Siyempre, my successor will do his own thing, or his own thing, kasi si isa lang ng kalaban niya, lalaki, wala si Hillary Clinton ngayon. So sabi ni President Trump, ano kaya pwede ko pang gawin kung sakaling hindi ako ma-elect? Alright. Ayun po yung ano lang, guni-guni lamang natin. But malay natin. Okay, ito yung House Appropriations Committee. Binigyan ang USCIS ng 183.9 million, which is very small compared to what the USCIS has been egging na 1.2 billion. Ang hinihingi ng USCIS is 1.2 billion emergency fund, pero ang binigay or ang appropriate ng House Appropriations Committee was only 183.9 million specifically to the USCIS. But huwag kayo mag-alala, because if you can see here, Let me highlight that. Ito, yung hinighlight ko po. 50.72 billion in discretionary funding. Okay? Discretionary funding. Ibig sabihin, the DHS has the discretion kung kanino ibibigay yung 50.72 billion sa mga agency. Because remember, there are three agencies under the DHS na nakaka-affect sa inyong petition or application. When you go to the US, then yung port of entry, ito yung Immigration and Customs Enforcement, ICE. When you're in the US, you want to apply for extension of stay or you want to change your status, then ito yung USCIS. If you border protection naman, yung pag nandun kayo sa Tijuana or sa Mexico, yung border CBP. So you have the ICE, the CBP, and the USCIS. So the DHS has been given the discretion to provide the funds, 50.72 billion. Eh, ano ba naman yung 1.2 billion na hinihingi ng USCIS, di ba? So, this way, it may placate. Pwedeng medyo mamasahe yung galit ng ibang mga congressman na galit sa USCIS because of its perceived anti-immigrant draft. So, dito, may amendments nga dito eh. Si Representative Pete Aguilar ng Democrat ng California, naglagay siya ng amendment na prohibiting deferred action for childhood arrivals and temporary protected status recipients from being removed from the country. So, hindi sila pwedeng alisin sa bansa kung mapapas itong appropriations bill na ito, then that's part of it. It's an amendment na pumasa dun sa committee. Okay? Another amendment is the amendment made by Representative Lucille Roybal Allard ng California din, prohibiting the ICE from using its funds to change a policy that students would have to attend only yung mga physical classes. So again, it's a reaction to what the USCIS mentioned before na sinabi nila, if you're a student, you're attending online school only, then you have to leave the US. But dun sa nakaraang hearing, sa court hearing sa Boston, and we mentioned that yesterday, sa Boston hearing, the USCIS did not even defend its action. So, pinabayaan na lang nila. So, bali parang nawala na ito, nawala na itong rule na ito ng USCIS. But, just in case, sabi nga ni Representative Ballard, just in case, magbago na naman ang isip ang CIS, kung ito'y nasa appropriations bill, hindi nila pwedeng baguhin. So, it will prohibit the USCIS from waiving in-person class requirements for international students. Ganun din, the USCIS, once this appropriations bill passes, may amendment na ito, kung ito'y pumasa hanggang sa ito'y maging batas, because you know how it is, inilagay din natin sa ating Facebook page yung how bill becomes law. From the appropriations committee, then it goes to the subcommittee for further research, or it goes to the floor for debate. Kung lumabas na ito sa debate, maging rule na ito, wala nang pwedeng gawin ng USCIS, because if the amendment passes na hindi pwedeng i-deport ang DACA, ang mga child arrivals, hindi pwedeng i-deport ang mga estudyante if they're attending online classes only, then that's it. It's good news for our students and deferred action arrival applicants. So, ulitin natin, while 183.9 million ang naka-allocate sa USCIS for this spending bill, the DHS has its discretion to use $50.72 billion para ibigay sa USCIS or any other agency under the DHS. So, okay, mag-alala. I'm sure that the DHS will give the USCIS more than what it needs. 1.2 billion? Chicken. Ano nga bang gagawin ko, sabi ni President Trump? Okay. So, ang next sa atin would be ito, yung processing flow. Processing flow, ito po yung how your petition travels from the USCIS lockbox, ito, USCIS lockbox, to the California Service Center, to the National Visa Center, then to the embassy at the consular post dito sa Pilipinas or anywhere else. Again, if you have any questions, you can text or call us 63-917-531-8472 or +63-917-526-8472. 8472. Yan po yung ating mga telephone numbers na you can text. Somebody will be able to answer your question immediately instead of waiting for me to answer your messages. Tulad nito, si Net Tumingod, PM, More Power, IBC, True Kabayan, Chris. Alright, thanks Net. Si Bong Jimenez, hello sir, hello. So hindi ko mababasang lahat yung mga sumasagot sa messenger. So if you have any visa or migration question, you can text or call us 63-917-531-8472 or 63-917-526-8472. Just in case kayo nagtataka, ayan po, ayan o. Oh. Kita yung ating t-shirt. Can you see that? Oh. Alright, that's from the United States Embassy dito sa Maynila. So, if you are able to go inside the embassy, meron silang parang souvenir shop. You can buy t-shirts, you can buy souvenirs from the US Embassy. Alright. Okay, sinuot po natin because of our broadcast. Now, just to remind you how to look for your receipt number and your processing para alam nyo kung saan kayong service center maghahanap, because there are at least 5 service centers that you can check the status of. Ito yung Vermont Service Center. And if you're looking for your case sa Vermont Service Center, your receipt number should either begin with EAC or Eastern Adjudication Center or VSC, Vermont Service Center. If your case is in California, then your receipt number should start with WAC or CSC. If your petitioner is in Nebraska, then your USCIS receipt should start with either LIN, that's for Lincoln, or NSC for Northern Service Center. If your petitioner is in Texas, then it's either NSC or SRC. So when you look at the because we shall be discussing the processing times, how it moved forward, gaano kabilis, from May to July. So that's about 2 months. So makikita natin. So in case you have your receipt number, alam nyo kung aling service center ang inyong titingnan when we discuss the processing times, just like here. California Service Center. So it's either CSC or WAC. So last May 22nd, the F2A sa California, they were processing those that were received by the service center July 6 of 2019. They predicted at the time, May 22nd, that it will take them 8.5 to 11 months to approve an F2A petition. So you can see here two things. One, you have the date, in this case, July 6, 2019. That means that's the date na huling na pinoprocess nila. So if your petition is July 7, hindi pa sila nakakarating sa iyong petition. They're only processing July 6, 2019. That was on May 22nd. But nung July 14, ano nangyari? Naku, umatras pa. Kaya ginawa nating red, oh. So instead of moving forward, yung F2A ay bumagsak pa ng halos 1 month. So now, the California Service Center is processing June 11, 2019. So marami siguro mga US Service Center employees ang hindi nakapasok. So overall, yung kanilang average processing time bumagsak. So now it will take them 10.5 to 13.5 months to process an F2A petition. So again, nung May 22nd, they said it will take them 8.5 to 11 months to process from filing to approval. It will take them 8.5 to 11 months. But this July 14, sinabi ng California Service Center, it will take them 10.5 to 13.5 months. At umatras pa. Imbis na nag-forward, it moved back. F1, nung May 22nd, April 21st, 2014, sabi nila it will take 53.5 months to 69.5 months bago ma-approve. Magandang balita. Bakit? Because nung July 14, it moved forward. Look at that. It moved forward by almost more than three years. See? For as of July 14, yung F1 ay June 12, 2017. And instead of 53.5 to 69.5 months, now it will only take them 29 to 37.5 months. So, good news for our F1 visa petitions. Bakit kaya ganun? marami kayong mga employees na nag-handle ng F2A ang hindi pumasok, kaya hindi na process, hindi naman pwede kasing ibigay nilang basta kung kani-kanino. So kung ito yung F2A section, ito yung F1 section, ito yung F2B section, yung F2A section, marami hindi nakapasok, so hindi na process. Yung F1, tuloy-tuloy lang, masisipag, masisinop, kaya mabilis ang processing. That's just my conjecture. I don't know, but maybe that's the case. At any rate, good news for F1. For F2B, it was August 16, 2014. Umabanti ito. Naging February 9, 2015. So it moved forward. And also, F3 also moved forward by 1 month. More than a month or almost 1 month. F4 also moved. No, F4, umatras din ang F4. So yung F2A saka F4, umatras siya. Yung F4 from February 3, 2009 naging January 9, 2009. Okay? So ang sabi pa nung May 22nd, it will take the USCIS California Service Center 104 and a half to 136 months to process the F4 petition. As of July 14, ang sabi nila it will take them longer from 106 and a half 238 and a half months. So, pag yun ay na-approve, saka pa lang kayo mapipila doon sa NBC. For petition ng US citizen for their spouse, parent, or minor child, the California Service Center is not processing this. It's being processed in other service centers. Which would be next? Tulad niyan, sa Potomac. Potomac Service Center. If you have any questions, you can text or call us +63 917 531 8472 or +63 917 526 8472. Sa Potomac Service Center, ang F2A ang pinoprocess ay October 25, 2019, nung May. And kung makikita niyo, lahat ito naging red. Yung F2A, yung F1, F2B, F3, lahat ng categories ay umatras. Ibig sabihin, naapektuhan yung mga employees ng Potomac Service Center. Either hindi sila nakapasok or whatever happens, I hope na hindi naman sila inabot ng COVID. But umatras, it moved backwards instead of going forward. As you can see, the F2A from October 2019 naging July. Yung F1 from August naging July. Yung F2B from October naging July. Yung F3 from August naging July. So all of it, all the preference categories, F2A, F1, F2B, F3, F4, hanggang F3 lang kasi walang F4 doon. So, lahat ito ay nag-move forward, backwards. Samantala, yung mga petition ng US citizen for their spouse, parent, or child, in May 22nd, it was August 27, 2019, umabanti siya ng October 18, 2019. So again, if you want to check where your petition is, you can check the USCIS receipt number, and that would include what the service center is for your specific petition. So that's for the Potomac Service Center. For the Nebraska and service centers, as of July 14, 2020, Nebraska F2A, August 3, 2018, sa Texas, December 17, 2019. So mas mabilis yung processing sa Texas, which is the SRC. Ito yung Southern Adjudication Center, o TSC. Yung F1, June 11, 2019, umabanti ng November 2019. Yung F2B ay from August 2018, mabilis sa Nebraska in Texas. Ito'y December sa Texas, November, August lang sa Nebraska. Sa Nebraska, for F3 is June 11, 2019. For Texas, ay November 2019. You can see all of this when you, later on, you can pause the recording because this is live. So when it is posted, it is recorded, you can watch the video, you can pause it and look at the information you need. Then you can go ahead and then resume viewing and then until the end of the video that we have. All right, so that's for Nebraska and Texas. For Vermont, the F2A is November 21st, 2018. For F1 is May 27, 2015. So, mas mabagal sa Vermont. Sa F2B is 2014. F3 is October 2011. and even sa IR1 and IR2 or IR5, June 19, 2018, if I may explain a little bit. If you're a U.S. citizen and you're filing a petition for your spouse, your parent, or your minor child, they are not covered by limitations. Hindi sila kasama sa quota. They are immediate relatives. Hindi katulad ng preference categories, yung F2A, F1, F2B, F3. They have limitations. So, kung mas maraming nag-a-apply, mahaba ang paghihintay. Uy, nag-remyo na. Kung maraming nag-a-apply, mahaba ang paghihintay. Samantala, yung IR1, spouse, IR2, minor child, IR5, parent of a citizen, they are not covered by limitations. Kaya, as long as na-approve na sila, immediately, visas are available. However, if you can see sa Vermont Service Center, ang pinoprocess pa lang sa Vermont Service Center ay yung petition ng U.S. citizen for a spouse, a child, or a parent noong June 19 of 2018. 2020 na tayo, so 2 years nakapending sa Vermont Service Center ang inyong petition. Whoa! E di parang para ka na rin preference category, hindi ba? Alright. But that's the way it is. That's the way the cookie crumbles, sabi nga ni President Trump. So, tingnan natin if the immigrant ban will be extended or it will only up until December 31st of 2020. Sabi ni President Trump. Extend ko kaya o hindi? Tingnan natin. If you have any questions, text or call 63917-531-8472 or 63917-526-8472. Now, let's see for the next. Tingnan natin ang ding epekto ng ban, immigration ban. From February to May of 2020, sa U.S. Embassy, yung mga nag-file ng petition na U.S. citizen for their spouse, parent, or minor child, noong February, ito ay U.S. Embassy lang sa Manila, hindi ito worldwide. Ito is specifically for those who have petitioned their spouses or children or parents in the Philippines, U.S. citizens ito. So, it is sa U.S. Embassy Manila. So, nung February, ang nabigyan na visa was 545. Nung March, bumagsak ng 247. Nung April, only 15. Last May, only 9 ang nabigay na visa because of the immigrant visa ban. I think that's a direct correlation. For the F1, nung February, 105. Nung March, 62. Nung April and May, nada. Zilch. 2 big zeros. Nada. 2 zero. April, 0. May, 0. Ayan. F2A. 236 nung February. 169 nung March. Nung April, 0. Nung May, 0. Talagang doble 0. F2B, ganun din. 177, 79, double 0. As for the F3, 71 nung February, 57 nung March, 5 nung April, at nung May, isa lamang 0 nung May. For the F4, brothers and sisters of U.S. citizens, 163 nung February, 109 nung March, 0 nung April, 0 nung May. Wala pa silang statistics for June. As soon as it's available, we shall share it with you. Worldwide. Ang nabigyan na visa noong February, 37,658. Bumaba ito noong March to 24,383. At ito'y bumagsak to only 1,521 noong April. At lalo siyang bumagsak noong May to only 697. For non-immigrant visas, noong May, 16 lamang ang nabigyan ng tourist visa. Yung mga seaman natin, only 5 seaman ang makaka-join sa kanilang barko if ever they're allowed to go. Yung H1B, only 2. For J1, isa. For K1, only 4 na fiancé ang pwede makapunta sa Amerika. Hopefully, nung nabigay yung visa sa kanila, merong flight, they were able to go. Hindi nag-expire yung kanilang visa because if their visa expires, then they would have to go to medical exam again, maybe pay another fee. So, madi-delay sila. Alright? But, as of May, B1, B2, only 16 visitors visa na nabigay. Seaman, 5. H1B, 2. J1 is 1. And for K1 is 4. Overall, ang binigay na visa noong February this year, 578,893. Nung March, it went down to 400,000. April, 46,000. Nung May, 40,000. So talagang bumagsak ang mga visa na ibigay because other than the immigrant ban, President Trump also banned the issuance of work visas that includes the H-1B, H-2B, J-1, and L-1. Kaya lalong bumagsak ang mga visa. So that's the immediate effect of the immigrant ban and the immigration ban ni President Trump. For dates of filing, sa visa bulletin, meron silang dates of filing. This is when you can start processing ang inyong visa application sa NVC. So, nung May, it was June 1st, 2011. So, if your priority date is on or before June 1st, 2011, then nung May, dapat nag-umpisa na kayo. Because nung June, it moved forward, naging September na. So, June, July, August, September. So, 3 months. So, nasayang ang 3 months ninyo kung hindi kayo nag-umpisa nung May. Nasayang nung, kasi nung June, it was September 1st. Nung July, it was already February 8th of 2012. So, umabanti na siya. So, kung hindi kayo nag-start ng processing nung May pa lang, maiiwan kayo. F2A, it was March 2020. Nung May 2020, naging May, then naging June. Yung F2B from February 2011, naging May, naging August. F3, August, November, and April of 2002. So, mabilis silang lumalakad. For our EB3, it got stuck mula nung May, it got stuck in April 1st of 2019. So, yun ang hindi magandang balita sa ating mga nurses, programmers, accountants, and other professionals. Hindi lumalakad ang processing time. But, tingnan naman natin yung interview date because as I mentioned, yung visa bulletin, they have two charts. The dates of filing, that means that if your priority date, tulad dito, kung sa July, if you're an F1 category and your priority date is, ito, I'm marking it. If your priority date is on or earlier than February 8, 2012, then you should start processing your visa application sa NVC. Tingnan natin ang date of yung final action. Because the final action is the date that you should have received your notice of interview. Kung hindi ka nag-process ng visa mo dun sa earlier, so balikan natin yung date of filing. Kung hindi ka nag-process, if you did not process your visa petition sa NVC nung May, June, and July, at ngayon mo lang titingnan ito, naiwan ka, nasayang ang 3 or 4 or 5 months mo na dapat ay nabigyan ka sana ng interview bago nagkaroon ng ban. So, yun ang pwedeng nangyari. However, for F1, ang binibigyan ng interview nung May was the petition filed nung September 1st of 2010. For this June, ang binibigyan ng interview yung petition on or before February 1st of 2011. For July 2020, this month, yung petition na naka-file noong June 1st of 2011, yun ang dapat meron ka ng interview notice. If the NVC is already sending interview notices sa embassy, remember ang embassy, sinabi nila, they have suspended processing until July 31st. But if you have documentarily qualified, if you have become documentarily qualified, that means na-process mo na yung petition mo sa NVC when the date of filing started, naumpisahan mo na. So, pwedeng natapos mo ng lahat, you have submitted your affidavit of support, you have uploaded your civil documents, you have corrected whatever entries they are, so now you are documentarily qualified. When your interview date is already current, tulad nyan, sa F1, if your priority date is June 1st, 2011, kung ngayon ka pa lamang mag-uumpisa sa NVC, maiiwan ka nung iba na nakapag-umpisa na sila. So, as for August 2020, oops, still waiting. Ayan o, yung hourglass, still waiting. Nawala na ng laman yung naghihintay, naging bungo na siya. Kahihintay, wala pa yung August 2020. When should the visa bulletin be out? The consular officers are required to report to the Department of State. Yung mga consular officer dito are required to report to the Department of State. Those who have been documentarily qualified. So, ganun din yung NVC. sila ay dapat magre-report kung ilan na yung documentarily qualified. So they can then apportion, malalaman nila kung ilan yung pwedeng ipamigay based on the allocation. So ito yung basis ng pag-publish nila ng visa bulletin. But lately, in the last several months, laging nahuhuli ang visa bulletin. And especially now, because of COVID, because of staff shortages, siguro hindi kulang sila ng tao para mag-process ng visa bulletin. So, nadi-delay siya. It should have been published every between the 9th and the 12th of the current month. For example, yung August visa bulletin should have been published between July 9 and July 12 of this month. But it's already July 16. Wala pa yung visa bulletin. Okay, paano nating malalaman na wala pa yung visa bulletin? Balikan natin. Let's see the visa bulletin. Ayan, visa bulletin. Current visa bulletin. You're watching what I have on screen. What I have on screen. So, nakalagay dito, current visa bulletin July 2020. Yung August ay coming soon. Wala pa rin. So, talagang wala pa. So, yun po yung ating live report. Balikan natin ito. So, yung August, still waiting. Ayan o. Medyo napunta na sa libingan kahihintay. Wala pa, hindi pa dumarating yung August 2020. But, just as a reminder, itong pinapakita natin cut-off dates are only for Philippine immigrant visa applicants. If you're watching and you're not a Filipino, then you would have a different final action date and date of filing dates. Yan po yung ating balita. So, when do you expect to be admitted as an immigrant? Kailan ka makakarating sa Amerika? Tulad nitong traveler na ito, nag-iisa lang siya dumating siguro. Wow! Iisa lang siya sa airport sa US na dumating. And empty yung airport. So it's never good to start your immigrant life on empty. But as long as you have your immigrant visa and you have your petitioner in the US, makakatulong sila sa inyo. So go ahead and do it. As long as you have your visa, go ahead and use it. If there's a flight, go ahead and fly. And where you're in the US, if you're ever required to go on 14-day isolation, at least na doon ka na kasama ng mga mahal mo sa buhay. Alright? Again, if you have any questions, you can text or call 63-917-531-8472 or 63-917-526-8472. Mga kababayan, 00, yun po yung mga maraming hindi nabigyan ng visa because of the immigrant ban. But let's see. As a reminder, the U.S. Embassy will make an announcement on or before July 31st if it will start processing visas again. Then we shall know whether the U.S. Embassy will follow the immigrant ban of President Trump not issuing visas until December 31st of 2020. Until then, salamat po sa inyong pagsama sa atin dito every time. If you're at the U.S. Embassy, you can get your souvenir. Alright? But until then, ito po ang inyong kabisang Chris Aranda nagsasabing sa likuran ng ating mga daon ng saging, hasta la vista, mga kabisa.